Russia, France's ally since 1892, was dragged into the conflict by Germany's declaration of war on August 1st, 1914. From 1914 to 1916, the Russian army had a series of hard-fought battles with the German and Austro-Hungarian forces on the Eastern Front. Tsar Nicholas II was not up to the task. His autocratic regime had been shaken by a first revolution in 1905. He had become more and more unpopular. On the front, the soldiers were tired of fighting, and in the rear, the population was suffering from famine. In St. Petersburg, a revolution led to the abdication of the Tsar in February 1917. The provisional government wanted to democratize Russia while continuing the war. But it met with the opposition of the Bolsheviks, who demanded social revolution and an immediate peace. The pacifist propaganda of the Bolsheviks encouraged the soldiers to cease combat. The year 1917 was one of discouragement everywhere in Europe. At the same time, the United States, exasperated by the all-out submarine warfare launched by Germany, entered the war on the side of the Entente. The first American soldiers disembarked at Saint-Nazaire on June 28, 1917. Meanwhile, Russia was in chaos. Soldiers refused to obey orders, and the country was on the verge of civil war. A last offensive in the summer of 1917 finished off the Russian army. On October 24, 1917, an insurrection organized by the Bolsheviks with the support of the St. Petersburg garrison and the cruiser Aurora overthrew the provisional government. One of Lenin's first acts was the peace decree of October 26th, requesting the belligerents to enter immediately into negotiations for a just and democratic peace. France and Great Britain refused all contact with the new Bolshevik government. Lenin thus decided to conclude a separate peace with Germany and the Austro-Hungarian Empire. On December 3rd, 1917, a Bolshevik delegation led by Kamenev arrived in Brest-Litovsk to negotiate with representatives of the Central Powers. The armistice was signed on December 15, 1917. The peace negotiations led to the Treaty of Brest-Litovsk, signed on March 3, 1918. Bolshevik Russia then abandoned immense territories representing a quarter of its population, a third of its agricultural resources, and a quarter of its industrial production. The disappearance of the Eastern Front allowed Germany to transfer a large number of its troops to the Western Front. It nevertheless had to keep occupying forces in the areas ceded by Russia. The General Staff headquarters, under Generals von Hindenburg and Ludendorff, then believed it could win the war thanks to its numerical superiority on the Western Front. But this was temporary, since the Americans were gradually swelling the ranks of the Entente. In Russia, a civil war had begun, opposing the Red Army, that of the new regime, and the White Armies, representing the Bolsheviks' opponents.
Subissant des moines. L'offensive lancée par l'armée de italien, un facteur migratoire bénéfique pour une zone chaude en pleine décomposition, assignée à son droit d'armistice, le droit de mort. Les Allemands sont de plus en plus seuls. Le 29 septembre, dans le quartier général de Spa, Guillaume de Hidalgo et Bonaparte acceptent une date d'armistice. Ils engagent alors des pourparlers avec les dirigeants de l'entente. Ils espèrent que le président Wilson, qui a publié son promesse de paix le 14 juin 1918, permettra à Allemagne d'obtenir des conditions acceptables. Mais Wilson exige de négocier avec un gouvernement démocratique et des troubles sociaux commencent à agiter l'Allemagne. Le 9 novembre, Guillaume II se résout à l'abdiquer, alors que la nouvelle République allemande est laissée par la révolution spartaniste. Le 11 novembre, le maréchal Foch reçoit la délégation allemande dans la clairière de l'Otan. Les Allemands sont contraints de voter contre la commission de l'armistice, signée par le commandement de Foch vers sa famille. Il prend des feuilles par un seul pour se mettre en route de ses enfants.
Il y a des choses. Era forte e fiabile, non so. Non ho capito di fatto forte. Vedo forte gru. Che si è
Thank you. Конечно, над головой не надо бомбить.